Densill Theobald and the government for the Darryl also. Can you assess the Darryl also Densill Theobald?
Well, it was slow because the poster has split our time on there. It was something we have been working on actually to keep more possession, because he always believed the team that has more possession always have a better chance of creating chances.
Do you think that's your objective was achieved in this game?
In the second half, I agree. But in the first half, we know we could have done a lot more.
As a player in this team, would you say that the long layoff at Trinidad and Tobago football has had, whether club level or internationally, has affected, you know, these, you're getting into gear for this campaign?
No, I wouldn't say so. The main objective was to win the game. You understand that to start the ball rolling for 2014, to give the fans something to be appreciated of. You know, knowing that they came out and gave us the full support in it. So we just wanted to start on a good foot, and we did that. We was proud of ourselves more especially in the second half than the first half, and we just have to keep working.
You thought about the performance of Stranger, you know, you can't stop that goal too.
Still, I've been working very hard in training, so for you guys who haven't been around me, I've been working really hard, and he was looking forward to this opportunity, and it was, you know, fortunate that he pulled it off in that goal.
To Darryl, are you confident that you'll be able to stamp a place to see in this team? You know, when the internationals come back, of course, it will be even harder. Are you confident that you are going to a place going forward?
We have been working hard as a unit, as a team. And for me personally, I just try to put in the hard work every day in training, and, you know, and leave it up to the coach, you know, and hopefully he sees good in me, and hopefully I can continue to help the team. Because as I said before, we work as a team, you know, and every individual has to put on the hard work out there.
Captain, you mentioned the goal was to win. What are the positives that are you taking away from the game?
Some more positives I'd like to take away from the game is the transition play, you know, from attack to defense, from the defense to attack. It's something I've been working extremely hard on in training with the German coach. And it's something that we implemented well in the second half especially.
Looking forward to the September 7th, who is the only good qualifying campaign? Are you satisfied with how far too much progress you have from this game?
Yeah, like I said, I'm more satisfied with the second half, you know, more than the first half. And like, we just have to move from here. With the internationals coming in next week to join some of the local based players, you know, we hope to push on from here.
And that's
give a strong performance
on the second half. Denzel, you emphasized about maintaining possession during the course of the game, right? How was your relationship on the field with Hugh and Hector, as you guys will be pivotal as essential midfielders and maintaining possession for Trinidad and Tobago?
Yeah, it was good, you know, but like I said, the second half was more better than the first half. The first half, you know, we could have done a lot much better. But like I said, we just have to keep working on it. And that's our first game, and we was able to get our main objective out of the game, which is to win the game.
But now you've been out of the team for quite a while. You came back, won a penalty, scored a goal. Are you satisfied with the performance? I want to see future life for Darryl.
As I said before, you know, all I have to do is try to work hard in training and try to give my best for the team and for the country. Understand, and as I put every day I put on a shirt, you know, I just try to put out 100% and try to do as good as possible for the country, and hopefully in terms of the coach and also the spectators, hopefully they can see some good in the team.
Skipper, first
of all, as you look forward now to the community, you know, seeing as it's a first game back, what are you looking to improve on and anticipate for now that day?
Like I said before, I'm just happy to be back. It's been a long 12 months, and I'm just looking forward to playing again. I need a couple more games under my belt for my fitness to get back up and a better sharpness, and everything's going to fall into place.
How would you rate your fitness at this time and your performance tonight?
80%. There's still a little bit of fine tuning we need to do. playing there. I think I can be a bit sharper around the box. Had a couple of chances tonight. Keep it down with someone. One end out, I should have done a bit better. I could have my feet a bit more, but it's gonna come. It's still a league boys, the preparation just started. So hopefully we can take the corner and do it.
Well, it's for the 78th International. That must be a good feeling. What is the feeling like, and how satisfied are you with the performance of the team and yourself today?
I think it was a good performance by the team today. I think we needed this game. I think this game could have been a better game for us, especially for the local players, because they've been down in bounce, because the last time they didn't qualify for the last round, and we didn't qualify for the local also. Most of the group of the second time. I think the local players and myself, they gave up their account for ourselves today. So hopefully we can go from strength to strength.
Of course, for the first time in about 10 years, you are considered a local leading player. What are your goals playing in Trinidad and for Trinidad?
Well, hopefully, I'm going to come back here and actually leave. I'm not going to come back here and just try to pick up the money and just try to go to the missions. Because I still have aspirations to play for the national team, and I have to work hard and continue working hard, and hopefully I can come back here and help the league, because our league here in Trinidad is a decent league, but we need that support from the fans that come back out and really support football in Trinidad. So if you may come back here, I can add that and bring something to it.
Well, still goal number 17 tonight. You've gone to 5th in the all-time list. 7 more to pass Kelly. That'd be a huge achievement. Do you have any targets, goals, strong ones?
I think that's when you play the game as a striker. You want to score goals, and you want to see the game on there. With the likes of Pete and stuff, I mean, that is going to be a wonderful achievement for me and my family and everyone. But also, hopefully, we can qualify for the World Cup. It would be amazing to be passing to Pete directly also. Hopefully, I can get to and see another World Cup, definitely.
Same with Coach Kristen, it seems like you have a lot of confidence in these seasons over 3 or 4 years and you were getting the national team. Do you think you have answered your critics who some may say that you're over the hill of the national team?
No, I mean, to be fair, the critics are always going to be there. I don't think I have anything to prove to the critics. Like I said, the more critics, the more they criticize me, I think I want to play even more, and I want to do a little more. So it's only going to help me. And when a manager comes in and he's giving me that assurance that, you know, you're one of the key players in this team, I mean, it's always a good feeling. And I've been looking after myself, so hopefully as I stay fit, I can easily work with that, I can be part of this team, I can play for a couple more years, definitely.
Looking forward to this game against Bermuda. I mean, we were in a very tight situation last time around, and a couple of new faces coming back into the team, you know, very familiar, yourself and Darryl, put this all in our room, you know. Is there any sentiment that you were from that last time going into this
game? I think last time our team was not sure what we have right now. I think we went into that game with a little confidence and a little cocky. And we had to pay for the Trinidad. We went to Bermuda and we had to grant the result. And that was football as a whole. Sometimes we took grant results. But I think we have a lot more players to add to the team. There were a lot of international players coming back, and it's going to be, I think the performance by the local players today is going to give the coach a headache, because I think they've done really well today. And like I said, it's going to give my headache to the team.
Thanks a lot, and just one reminder, accreditation for the World Cup qualifiers begin next week. We'll send out an advisory, and the process starts on Wednesday. So we invite you guys to come down to the office, because we are going to take images of you for the PC election.